Hey guys, welcome back to another video. I just want to talk about a very small thing today in this video, which is about what design is actually and what designers do. So design is basically fundamentally an amalgamation of different industries, different domains, different types of skills, and essentially what designers do is basically a problem solving. A job of a designer and that of a doctor is pretty much the same. You have some issue, you go to the doctor, the doctor solves your issue, he solves your problem. You have a pain point, you have some uneasiness, the doctor solves it. The same way designer works in an industry. You go to a designer and tell him that, yeah, this is my company and my logo doesn't look good, my logo doesn't look professional, my communication with my customers is not that good. It's a problem, right? You're solving a problem. So be it fashion industry, be it graphic industry, be it product industry, be it animation or film design, you are fundamentally solving an issue, a problem, a need which your customers have, right? So solving a problem goes in a very methodical way, in a step-by-step way. There is huge amount of logic into it, there is a story behind it, there is a process behind it. And when I see some of the work on the group and otherwise also, people confuse design with art. In art, you just have self-expression. And in that self-expression, you don't need to do any research, you don't need to read about stuff, you don't need to take any research, you don't need to study about things. Art is complete self-expression. Koi aapko nahi bolega ki yaar ye red ke saath yellow kyun laga diya, blue kyun nahi lagaya, and all that thing. But when it comes to design, it involves a lot of logic by default. It involves a lot of reasoning, it involves a lot of justification to it. So my point is, when you are trying to become a designer, don't lose that logical side of your thinking, don't lose that rationality, don't lose that reasoning thinking. That's why there are reasoning questions in all these design exams. So you have to reason that aapne ye font choose kyun kiya, you have to reason ki aap is type ki car kyun bana rahe ho, you have to reason ki ye animation mein aisa character kyun hai, you have to reason ki ye film mein is type ka story kyun hai, you have to reason ki maine ye product aise hi kyun banaya hai, why these colors, why this texture, why this material, why this kind of process put into it, and all those things. So jaise doctor bahut zyada padhai karte hain, the same way that doctor goes through a lot of books, a lot of theory, a lot of literature, a lot of text, the same way designer also need to read a lot. And a lot of students who are preparing for design exams just ignore that part, which is not good, which won't help you in the long run. And if you think that you will do it in the later stages, it's not possible. You cannot read 20 books in 20 days, right? And remember it. So my point is, start reading from day one. Start reading and make it a habit in your day-to-day preparation. Because if you don't know the logic about certain things, you will not be able to justify it. आपने बहुत अच्छा design भी बनाया, but अगर आपको interview में किसी ने पूछ लिया कि आपने ऐसा ही क्यों बनाया, वैसा क्यों नहीं बनाया, and now you just have one answer, I thought of it that way and I just made it. So the chances are they will not accept you, they will reject you, because you are thinking like an artist. You just got some idea and you started painting it. And even if you get selected in future, if you go for a job and you work in an industry, people may reject your ideas, people may reject your resume, or people may reject your candidature for a particular company just because you're logically not matching their expectation, right? So as a designer, learn a lot of things and be very confident about your judgment, be very confident about why you chose this one particular idea and rejected the other 10, right? So two things are very important: you knowing a lot of stuff so that you can figure out which one is right and which one is suiting the context, and then you studying a lot of stuff, you analyzing a lot of stuff. What I mean by studying and analyzing is, suppose I gave you an assignment to redesign the Airtel logo tomorrow, and you just come up with one A or maybe Airtel in a new font. That's not it. You have to study why I need to redesign the Airtel logo. What is the communication behind redesigning the Airtel logo? What kind of audience we are communicating with, and why we need a change? What kind of change we are expected to do? Right, all those things are there, and it goes with all the disciplines of design. It's not that if it's a ceramic design thing, so I will not consider any logic or any research or anything like that. It's not that way. Even when you choose colors for a logo, there is a lot of logic behind it. There's a lot of study, theory, and research behind it. So my point is, don't just focus about the next step, which is your exam. Don't just think that I need to crack NIFT or NID or CEAT and that's about it. No, you ultimately want to be a designer, and if you want to be a designer, this is the approach that you need to build and start working on it from day one. And because it takes a lot of time to get used to this kind of approach, train your brain to this level, I would suggest that start doing it from day one. Take your things seriously and consider yourself as a future designer. That's why I named that group as GNID Future Designers, because you are ultimately going to be a designer, right? So it's good if you consider yourself a designer from day one and start your expectations, start your ideation from that level. Start expecting your own work and performance from that level. You should not just do random things and think that, oh, I am a designer or I am going to be a designer. No, think that you are a designer, and then you need to present that design to an audience, to a client, to a job or to an interview, and then you have to think from a perspective ki aap log mujhse question puchenge. Now people will ask like, what is the logic, what is the reason, why this, why not that, and all those things. You have to be mentally prepared for that, right? And if you start doing it this way, if you start thinking about your own work from this angle, trust me, you will improve 10 times faster, right? So this is it, guys. I wanted to communicate this thing for a very long time, but then I thought, like, let me gather my thoughts together and then put it in a video. So this is what I want you to work on. This is what I expect that you will pick up fast and improve on it, right? There's no point in doing some random portraits or random sketch of a car or a SUV or anything like that, or just sketching a Lamborghini and feeling good about your work. It's not about that. Design is much deeper, logical, and there has to be a lot of reasoning and study behind what you do. Sketching is good for the skill part, but in sketching also you should go to that level where you can consider yourself as a designer and not just an artist. Okay, so consider this difference in mind and start building your thinking pattern that way. Okay, so I hope you get my idea. I hope I'm able to communicate it to you well, and I hope you will work on it. So that's it, guys. Till then, bye bye. Take care. See you in the next video.